As you might know, you can use binary math to figure out subnets, to figure out what IP addresses to use, to figure out what subnets to use, to figure out how many subnets you can have, to figure out, let's see, what else? Network addresses, broadcast addresses, all of that stuff. There is an easier way, though, and that is using magic number subnetting, the magic number method for figuring out IP addresses. So, reminder, subnetting is dividing a network into smaller networks. So if we're taking a large network and we need to make 3 smaller networks or 5 smaller networks or 100 smaller networks, depending on the needs of your organization, you can do that. Subnetting is the name for that process. So the subnet mask, remember, tells us where the network address ends and the host address begins. And so you've got class full subnet masks, which are the class A, the class B, the class C, and then you've got classless subnet masks, unclassy subnet masks that can be any length that you want. And that's the slash, you know, 15 slash 20 slash 22, etc. And the subnet mask is always a bunch of ones followed by some zeros. So reminder from the simple IP addressing video, if the subnet mask number is 255, then the network address number is the IP address number. If the subnet mask number is 0, then the network address number is 0. Easy peasy. Where this comes in and where you need to worry about anything other than bringing numbers down or making the numbers into 0 is when you've got anything other than a 255 or a 0 in the subnet mask. And remember, because subnet masks with classless routing can be any length at all, that's why we've got to deal with this. And so if you see a number that's not 255 or 0, you have to think to yourself, hey, something's going on here. I got to figure out what's going on. So let's figure this out. The first step in this magic number method is figuring out the interesting octet. And the interesting octet is the number in the subnet mask that's not a 0 or a 255. And because the subnet mask is all ones followed by all zeros, there's only possibly one number that's not a 0 or 255. Maximum one number. There might be no numbers that are not a 0 or 255. It might all be 255s and zeros, in which case you don't have to worry about magic numbers. You just do it the simple way. But if you do have an interesting octet, find what that is and find that number in the subnet mask and find that number in the IP address. Once you have the interesting octet and have identified which one that is, you can do the magic number calculation. And the magic number calculation is 256 minus whatever that number is in the subnet mask. Remember, it's the number in the subnet mask that matters here. So 256 minus whatever the interesting octet number is in the subnet mask, whatever number is not 255 or 0. And we will do some examples of this whole process, a couple examples of the whole process. So don't worry about it. I'm introducing the process right now. And once you have identified what that magic number is, 256 minus the interesting octet, then to identify the network address, you take the number from the interesting octet in the IP address. Remember, I told you you'd need both numbers. Take that number from the IP address, start at 0, and add the magic number to itself over and over again until you reach the number in the octet, in the interesting octet in the IP address without going past it. And with that, you have the network address. Because remember, with the others, with the 255s and with the zeros in the subnet mask, you could just pull those down. So the only one we're worried about and the only one that's difficult is figuring out that interesting octet. Boom, with that, you've got the network address. Then you add the magic number again, and that gives you the next network address. So remember, because you've got these multiple subnets now that are sequential and right next to each other, if you add the magic number again, as long as the total is less than 256, once you hit 256, and they will add up to 256, once you hit 256, then you're done and you have no more subnets. So you add the magic number again, now you have the next network address, take one away in the interesting octet, and you've got your network's broadcast address. Again, we'll show some examples. Just hold on to your hats for just a second. Let's do it. Let's do an example. So 201.215.128.65/28. Remember, if it were /24, then it would be 255.255.255.0. But it's /28, so we have to figure out what that is. And what that means, and the whole process here, we're going to figure out what the subnet mask is first. And 255, 255, 255, that's the first three numbers in the dotted decimal format. And then we have to figure out what that last number is. That accounts for slash 24. That means four bits are left, 28 minus 24. Four bits left, that means the last number is 11110000. I hope that was four ones and four zeros, just like the number on your screen. So 1111 is 128 plus 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 16, because that's what those bits are in binary. That is 240. So then our subnet mask is 255, 255, 255, 240. So we have that. Now we need to figure out our network address, starting with the interesting octet. We know that where there's a 255 in the subnet mask, the network address number is the same as the IP address number. So we know that because it's 255, 255, 255, 240, the first three numbers are the same as in the IP address 201, 215, 128. What's the last one? That's going to be our interesting octet. So our magic number, again, we take that interesting number from the subnet mask. In this case, that's 240. And we subtract that number, 240, from 256. So 256 minus 240 is 16. Our magic number is 16. So magic number is 16, the interesting octet in the IP address is 65. We take the magic number and add until we get to 65 without passing. 16 plus 16 is 32, plus 16 is 48, plus 16 again is 64. If we go past 64, then we're gonna go past 65. So, and 65 is the number in the IP address, so 64 is gonna be that number in our network address. So our network address is 201.215.128.64. The next network, remember we add that magic number again, the next network is going to be 201.215.128.80. And then if we subtract one from that, then our broadcast address is 201.215.128.79. So that is the broadcast address on our network. We have identified the next network. We've identified the network address. The number of hosts on the network is, you know the process. It is the number of host bits, and we can get that purely from the subnet mask. So it's 2 to the 4th power, because there are 4 host bits, minus 2 is 14 hosts on the network, and the addresses are from that .65 to the .78. So .79 is the broadcast address, 1 minus that is the last host on the network. The network address, 65 plus 1, or 64 is the network address, plus 1 gives us the first host on the network. So, easy peasy, right? I know I went kind of fast. You can go back and watch it again a little bit slower. Make sure you can follow the process and where each of these steps fit together and which numbers I'm pulling where, because the challenge is going to be remembering when to pull in a number from the IP address and when to pull in a number from the subnet mask. The process itself and the math itself is pretty simple. It's just a matter of remembering which numbers go where. So we've got the subnet mask, we've got the network address, we've got the broadcast address, we've got the number of hosts, and the number of addresses on the network. So one more example, just to make sure the process makes sense and to make sure that you can figure out which numbers go where. And we're going to make this one a little bit harder by shifting it over into the middle of the IP address. Sometimes things are a little easier if they're at the very end or at the beginning. So we're going to use a slash 19 subnet. So 16.25.123.15/19. So again, the first thing we need to do is figure out what the subnet mask is. 255.255 accounts for 16 bits of that 19, leaving us 3 bits left. That means the third number in the subnet mask is 111 followed by 5 zeros. And 111 followed by 5 zeros, binary. The first digit is 128, the second digit is 64, the third digit is 32, the rest of them are all zero. So 128 plus 64 plus 32 is 224. 224. So 255.255.224.0, because everything after the subnet mask changes is zeros. So if we know that then that the subnet mask is 255.255.224.0, how do we get the network address? Well, the easy parts are done already on the screen. You take the number where there's a 255 in the subnet mask, you take the number from the IP address. Where there's a 0 in the subnet mask, you put a 0 in the network address. And so it's 16.25.something, we don't know yet because we've got an interesting octet here, .0. That is the process for figuring this out. So we have 16.25 something in that middle there, .0, that is our network address. So now we can do the magic number calculation and figure out what goes in that middle spot, in that third spot. So our interesting octet, the number in the subnet mask is 224, so we're gonna take 256 minus 224, that gets us 32, that is our magic number. The magic number is 32. So then we are going to take the magic number and add it to itself until we get to 123 without passing it. It's important that you don't go past it, because once you go past it, then you're on to the next network, and an address cannot be on the next network if it's on one network. So 32 plus 32 is 64 plus 32 again is 96. And remember, you might be tempted to add numbers to themselves. So you might want to go 32 plus 32 is 64 plus 64 is 128. Don't do that. Make sure you're using that magic number. That's a common kind of gotcha that's going to catch you if you're not careful. So 32 plus 32 plus 32 gets us to 96 plus 32 again gets us to 128, which is past 123. So we got to back right back up there to 96 and stop there. So 16.25.96.0 is the network address. So we have that network address. We've got the subnet mask number. We've got the network address written right there. The next network, if we add the magic number again, is 16.25.128.0, because remember, 96 plus 32 gives us 128. So with the next network address of 16.25.128.0, we can subtract 1 from that interesting octet to get the broadcast address for our network. Remembering that how the broadcast address works, it's all ones in the host bits, which means if there's a 0 in the subnet mask, it's gonna be a 255 for the broadcast address. So take that interesting octet, subtract 1, 16.25.127, which is 1 less than 128.255. That is the broadcast address for our network. Subtract 1 from only the last number in that, from the 255, to get the last host on the network, so 16.25.127.254. And we add 1 to our network address of 16.25.96.0, turn that into 16.25.96.1 to get the first host on our network, and use that number of hosts, so 13 host bits on that network, because we have 32 bits in a subnet, or 32 bits in an IP address. 19 of those are reserved for the subnet mask, meaning there are 13 remaining. 2 to the 13th minus 2 is 8,190 addresses. And we're subtracting 2, remember once again, for the network address at the beginning and the broadcast address at the end that can't be assigned to hosts. So subnet mask 255.255.224.0, network address 16.25.96.0, broadcast address, we've got that figured out, number of hosts on the network, and then the first and last addresses. So that means that everything from 16.25.96.1 to 16.25.127.254 is on that same network, which means you might have an address that doesn't look the same. If you're used to seeing addresses that share all the same numbers sharing a network, that's not necessarily the case. So 16.25.96.20 and 16.25.115.5 are both on the same subnet. So just keep that in mind. You might see numbers that might not look like they're on the same network, but they are, just because of the way this works. But 16.25.130.2 is on the next network up. And that is the magic number method for calculating subnet addresses.